There's always been a running debate in this country about the pros and cons of immunising babies, but in the third world, yes, it still exists, a staggering number of kids are still dying from common everyday diseases. It's a pretty grim subject, but of late, global drug companies, not always known for their compassion, have been making vaccines cheaper. Here's Danny Isdale.
A tiny jab that could save this little girl's life, and she's one of millions. In Mozambique, 8-month-old Claudia has been hospitalised with pneumonia. It's the world's biggest child killer. Diarrhoea comes a close second, taking the lives of more under fives than AIDS, measles and malaria combined.
In a country like Australia, we can actually fix that. But when you're in the field, as we do with Médecins Sans Frontières, you literally see children dehydrate in front of your eyes, kids who haven't got to a hospital quick enough, who have had diarrhoea for 2-3 days, that's all it takes for them to die.
Dr. Coatsworth would know. He's been treating children in Chad, Darfur and the Congo for 7 years.
In the developing world, we really need to get the vaccination numbers up to 70, 80, 90% of children, and we are so far away from that.
Now to help reach that goal, GlaxoSmithKline is leading a group of pharmaceutical companies radically discounting vaccines.
This is an example of our tiered pricing approach. What that simply means is we charge higher prices for the wealthier nations, less for the middle, and the poorest get the absolute lowest price.
So its rotavirus vaccine will sell to Western countries at $45.70 a dose. For emerging nations such as China and Brazil, it's $9.15. And for those who need it most but can afford it least, the vaccine costs about $2.30.
Our prices in the West haven't changed at all. This particular vaccine, for example, has been on the market since 2004. There's already been 100 million doses of this vaccine sold. We're not changing any of those prices. None of these prices are going up because of what we've announced today. This is a case of and, not or.
GlaxoSmithKline has taken an important step towards ensuring children's lives are saved, but now we need world leaders and other pharmaceutical companies to follow suit.
Foreign aid, including $60 million from Australia over the next 3 years and $250 million over the next 20, funds the Global Alliance for Vaccines and Immunisation Body.
Right now, it's struggling to try and make up a funding shortfall of $3.7 billion. So it's holding a pledging conference in London on Monday to ask for those billions from representatives of developed nations, including our Foreign Affairs Minister, Kevin Rudd.
And 630 understands he's open to considering committing more aid.
And I know people are doing it tough in Australia, people doing it tough around the world, but this really is, per capita, quite a small amount of money to save a life.